Okay, I left off on that. But let's get back to this review. Let's talk about Anastasia, shall we? What is up, guys? It's me, Casey, of your Kids Movies Kid Shows. Now, let's talk about Don Bluth, shall we? Now, I love this guy. I mean, I love pretty much all his films that he was doing. And while kind of a guilty pleasure of scenes that weren't exactly that good, I did. But there was one film that I kind of find myself liking. And that is, of course, the movie we'll take a look at today, obviously, Anastasia. Released in 1997, directed by Don Bluth, Anastasia was based off a real-life event. Well, keyword loosely based on a real-life event. It happened in Russian history, about a revolution against the Romanov family. And, well, it's gonna take a few liberties here and there. They made a lot of stretches in this film. Now, that doesn't make it a bad thing, but hey, we saw a loosely based real-life events before in animation form, especially from Disney. And of course, it being an animated film, it of course needs some music numbers. DJ, if you please.
Yo, it's the DJ up in here, yo. Oh, and let me tell you, yo, the musical songs are really, really good, yo. Especially my favorite song, In the Dark of the Night, yo. It's really cool up in here, yo. There's also a few romance songs and about Anastasia find out her past, and it's really, really fly, dog. And of course, that comedy bit with the Russians trying to teach Annie how to be royalty and all that stuff, that's really, really funny, dog. Word up, dog.
Thank you, Mr. DJ. Anyway, we got our main characters. Anastasia, of course, aka Annie, because, well, she still have her memory loss during the revolution. And she had a memory loss during the revolution and all that stuff, you know. If you all saw this movie. But yeah, she suffered memory loss while her and her grandmother was trying to retreat from the angry revolutionaries. And there's the love interest in Dimitri, of course, because it's an animated film. That's not Disney, that. Anyway. Hey, Vladimir, the comic relief sidekick slash mentor. And finally, the cute and cuddly puppy. Named Porto. Aww. And well. They go on misadventures here and there, especially those caused by the villain of the movie. We'll talk about him in a bit. And well, of course, Annie and Dimitri fall in love with each other, because, you know, for a movie that says it's not an animated Disney film, it certainly is like a Disney film. Well, it's a Disney film now, considering that Disney now owns Fox. Even Disney will own everything one day, including the world. Nah. Anyway, this movie stars Anastasia, as stated before, and her trying to find her family, or what's left of her family after a revolution. But with her friend's help, they're able to recover her memories. But she chooses to stay with Dimitri because, well, obvious reasons. But it's nice to see Anastasia still love and care for her family, even though that she's leaving them again. But hey, on a better note. Now let's get our main villain, shall we? Rasputin. And funny thing about him, he actually does exist. But in this anime film, he's a power mad sorcerer. I'm getting some strange Disney villain vibes. I mean, he's like a Russian Jabbar, if you will. And of course, like in what happened to him in the real history, he met his untimely demise at a glass lake. Well, an icy glass lake, and drowned, and he either drowned or freeze to death in the cold. But after his demise, he became an undead sorcerer who still wants to kill Anastasia. Okay, dude, I know that the Romanovs kicked you out of the palace and stuff like that, but still. I mean, seriously.
Stop right there!
Dr. Nerd? What do you got to say about this?
Bluntly, this movie is historically inaccurate! There was no musical numbers. Rasputin never was a dark evil sorcerer. He was a religious guy who tried to manipulate his way to power. He was never a dark evil sorcerer. And not only that, he did not use evil magic to influence the mind of the citizens of Russia to start a revolution. He did not do that of not. The people did it because they had their own original belief and stuff like that. And they didn't do it on the devil made it for it. That is more donkey. Yes, a cross between a bull and a donkey. I call shenanigans on all of this. And it also never was a talking bat. So yeah, that historically accurate. Anastasia and Rasputin was never like this in the movie. Oh, and that's why I can say it's Dr. Bird, not Dr. Nerd. How often I was telling you?
Thank you for the information, Doc. But yeah, well, that's something. Let's talk about Batroc, shall we? Yes, he's the funny talking animal sidekick in this film. And, well, he's pretty much the Iago of the movie. And, yes, apparently he was popular enough to get his own spinoff movie for some reason. Why? I have no clue. Your guess is as good as mine. So, overall, this was a fun and entertaining movie. I mean, sure, it's historically inaccurate. But still, they didn't stop it from being good. And it was a pretty good film. And, well, when I saw it on the big screen, I thought it was phenomenal and all that stuff. It may not be a Disney film, well, okay, it is now, but still. And, well, if there was going to be a live-action remake, I hope it'll be on par with this. Or, at least, almost on par. Overall, I give this a 9 out of 10. It was almost good, but it had problems, sure, but still. An almost perfect film. It's above average, yep, but almost perfect, you know. Well, that's all for today, guys. See you all next time.
Farewell, friends. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and DeviantArt.